Well, we have seen a massive increase in counterfeit goods, especially the DVDs for film as well as the music CDs. And we are worried as the Department of Trade and Industry, and we think that as government we have to invoke certain sections of the law to ensure that we are able to clamp down on those, because the impact to our society and these artists in particular is huge in terms of financial losses that they experience. Hence we are here today, and I'm very much happy with the raid. I think it has been successful. We have found those who are doing wrong activities in such formal facilities without the landlord explaining exactly why they are housing criminal activities in their own. We will be following up as government through law enforcement agencies to ensure that we clamp down on such activities in the future.
We will get a copy of the lease agreement from the management of the centre, and we're actually busy with a program to help have the owners of these shopping areas also responsible in adding them to the dockets, in aiding and abetting a crime. Because they get rental income every month from these stores, and we have warned them that they should be careful in terms of the things they sell. So if we find any counterfeit DVDs in this shop or music, we will go through it now. It will be written up in a detailed inventory. We will confiscate it in terms of the Counterfeit Goods Act, and we will bring criminal proceedings against the suspects. And their details will be on the
list. It's very clear these guys are doing it with impunity. I mean, they don't care about your laws, bylaws and stuff. Here, you're in a center similar to Montana traders. They normally, the hawkers, get them here. They sell them as though these counterfeit goods are illegal. Because for the fact that they pay rentals here. So these guys, remember, artists, they pay taxes, they go all out, compose the table, they've done, they've got a budget from various record companies and movie houses. But these guys, they don't have to. They just have to wait for the awards, whether summer awards, metro awards, sports awards. Then they buy a heater. Whoever is a winner in the summer, so metro, so the post town awards, then they go out and make a, you know, a fortune. So something needs to be done. We want the political parties in parliament to speak out. I mean, you see debates on a daily basis. So all political parties must speak out against this economic, you know, form of sabotage. This is economic crime, and it's not acceptable.